Hey everyone, it is Havo High here, bringing another video on Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle. In this video, we're going to be discussing the global timeline once again for the year ending 2020 and for the beginning of 2021. So with that, if you're new to my channel, like, subscribe, comment below, do all that good stuff, and always a shout out to DBZ Space and the Dokkan Wiki for info and images provided. So here we are again, we have more news of what's going to be coming up for the rest of the Christmas celebration and for the New Year celebration. I guess the biggest question is what's going to be after the New Year celebration. We're going to dive right into it right here. So first and foremost, this is where we're at right now. We have the Dokkan Festival exclusive LR Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken Evolution Vegeta banner up, LR Beyond Blue. Then we have the worldwide celebration or the worldwide legendary summoning banner of LR Tech Super Saiyan 2 Gohan, and of course the EZAs to Kellen Khalifa. We also had a chain battle, which was interesting. And then also with the chain battle, we do have some other EZAs with the Peppy Gals and stuff like that. So that's what's been happening in December. So we know that's what we are experiencing now. So the second part of this will be the 24th, Christmas Eve or Christmas, depending on where your time zone is. It should be dropping a bunch of different things. Number one, it's going to be the dropping of the Tanabana banner, which is going to be the Christmas banner. So we saw the summoning tickets in the data download. So that's going to be available on the 24th/25th. And then they're going to be dropping the brand new 10 new category stages for Super Battle Road. And that's going to coincide with a new reward in LR Tech Gohan and Goku. And then, of course, the legendary awakening for OG Prime Battle LR Super Saiyan Goku. I think everybody's excited about that as well. So these three things are going to be dropping on Christmas. And there's a lot of stuff to do here for about a week before the New Year celebration. And we know about the New Year celebration as well, which is kind of a surprise. They ended up doing the data download on that as well. And we know that first and foremost, we're going to get a step-up banner. So we know that's going to happen. Now, we don't know if it's going to be like four rounds, because 2 years ago it was two rounds, last year it was three rounds. But now it's going to be, you know, this new step-up banner for New Year's, which is a step at 20, 30, 50, 50, and then a guaranteed LR. The biggest question here, if you want to summon on this banner, is if what LRs are going to be on this banner, because it's a limited amount of LRs. Not all the LRs that's previously on as a non-Dokkan Festival exclusive is going to be on this banner here. So it'll be very interesting to see what's on this banner, and I hope it goes up to UI Goku, because if UI Goku's on this banner, I think a lot of people would summon on this banner here. But if it's like Kellen Khalifa is the highest, then I think less people are actually going to be summoning on this banner, even though it's a guaranteed LR. So I think for value wise, one round is good. But if you're well and pay to win and pay to play, then I don't know if you'll go all three rounds. And I actually don't know if it's going to be three rounds this year. I think it will be. So anyway, so that's what we're going to get New Year's, or you know, New Year's Eve into New Year's. And then we're also going to be getting dropped the World Tournament, which was kind of a surprise. So we have this information. The World Tournament is going to run from 12/31 to 1/3, and that, you know, makes total sense. That's usually the case. Well, actually to 1/2, I guess, right? So Thursday, no, 1/3. And the World Tournament should end when the brand new celebration happens, because on 12/31, all the banners disappear that we currently have right now. So the Beyond Blue and the Super Saiyan 2 Gohan LR banner, those are going to be, you know, stopped at 12/31, and the only banners that we're going to have is the Step Up banner and the Tanabana banner, right? So here's the big question, right? 1/3/2021, what's going to happen? Well, we know that 2000 Day Goku is going to be dropping, and I think they might even mention that during Christmas, right? But where my calculations are is 1/5/2021 is the first time you can actually, if you logged in every day since launch, that's the day that it will be available for you. So unless you got early access somehow, things of that nature, 1/5/2021 is when the first arrivals of the 1000 Day Goku EZA, 2000 Day Goku. The biggest question is, what's going to happen on 1/3/2021? Because you have a couple options, right? It can be an introduction to a new Dokkan Festival exclusive celebration, or it's going to jump right into an LR banner. Now, it can go either way, right? It can go either way because when you think about it, the two banners that it's up, it's a special banner when it's a Dokkan Festival exclusive special banner, the Christmas Tanabata banner. That's a Dokkan Festival exclusive banner there. Then you have the LR banner, which is like a legendary summoning banner, but it's also a Dokkan Fest banner as well. So very difficult to kind of navigate through this. So the two choices, it's either going to be the legendary summoning banner for Jiren, and that's what we've been waiting for, which I think is very likely that that's going to be the case, or it's going to be one of the three Dokkan Festival exclusives that are remaining that has been introduced on JP. So let's speculate here. This is all speculations. These are not guaranteed at this point in time. So if it is going to be Jiren, that's what most of us are looking forward to, right? Is, hey, Jiren was supposed to come out when LR Beyond Blue came out, but Gohan ended up taking that spot. So we still want the Jiren. We want the EZA to, got Topo and Dispo. So I think this is very likely that they're going to be dropping the legendary summoning banner for Jiren and EZA-ing Topo and Dispo in the first half of the new year. So this would be the 1-3 celebration, and then in mid-January or later in January, they're going to either introduce a Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta or the Bojack, right? So one of the two I think will happen on there. I don't think we're gonna get Frieza. So kind of going back to this spot here, Frieza, I think it's gonna come in March. I just have a feeling that it's gonna happen March or late February, somewhere around there. I think this out of these three would be the latest one. It's gonna be pushed a little bit further. For some reason, that's why I feel. I think we're gonna get Bojack earlier, and I think we're gonna get Super Saiyan 4 earlier. So I think the one that most people are hoping for in Frieza, I think we'll get that in March or late February. But anyway. So going back to this idea here, I think this is very likely it's going to happen. Or if they switch it up, they say, okay, let's go ahead and just provide the Dokkan Festival exclusive banner to go along on 1-3, which would have been maybe the Gogeta banner, right? So Gogeta comes out, you got the Dokkan Awakenings to the Migra, the Mira and Toa, and then have Jiren a couple weeks afterwards. I think a lot of people will be kind of upset about this. So because it's still waiting on Jiren. But if they're going to go normally with a Dokkan Festival exclusive, then into an LR, this would be kind of how it would actually look. Now, once again, Jiren's a little bit of a special LR, right? It's 170% lead, so it's not a normal LR. So that's why I think this is more likely, because this is more of a special unit, so having it during the New Year's, the front end of the New Year celebration makes sense, and then going into a Dokkan Festival exclusive. So this would be the Gogeta version of it, and then if it was Bojack that came out early, then it might look like something like this into Jiren as well. So you have Bojack, you have the EZA to Timebreaker Bardock, things of that nature. So that can possibly happen. So if they go Dokkan Festival exclusive, I think one of these two. I don't think we're going to get Frieza, like I said, until later. But if they do it this way, I could be okay with it, right? I can be okay with Gogeta coming out first and then waiting for Jiren in part two. But I think most people want this right here. So, and I'm going to go with this as the prediction, speculation, is we are going to get, and I'm actually going to take Bojack out. I'm going to remove Bojack. And we're going to get Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta next. I think this will be the celebration. I think Gogeta will lend itself to at least some hypeness to kind of counterbalance what's going to happen on the JP version of the game, which is a 6-year anniversary. So I think they need some sort of hype to mitigate that on global, because global will get kind of antsy while the crazy hype is going to happen for 6-year anniversary. So anyway, tell me what you guys think. Do you guys think it's going to be something like this? Do you guys think it's going to be a Dokkan Festival exclusive first, like Bojack or Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta? Or this is more likely what's going to happen. So with that, tell me in the comment section below. Tell me all your thoughts and hopes and dreams for this Christmas / New Year celebration and ongoing in 2021. And so with that, if you're new to my channel, like, subscribe, do all that good stuff. And thank you all for watching. Keep on Dokkaning, and we'll catch you next time. Later.